All right, so it's crit time, so I gotta go and endure all the talk. See what happens.
Okay, so project 2 was basically about comparing high art and low art from the Manil, which is a museum, and Fiesta, the grocery store. So I'm allow y'all to see some of the photos I use in my paintings. I didn't put all of them up because of the Manil. I don't want any legal actions happening. So I'm going to let y'all take a look at those first before getting into my paintings. I painted this one on the hard backing from one of my drawing tablets. It's the Michael Heiser sculpture that's in the ground in front of the Manil. I replaced the area that has dirt in it with the wet floor sign. And at the top where the horizon is, where people are normally walking around and there's trees, I replaced that with the red handle baskets from the Fiesta. This one is Rosenquist inspired with the three sectionals. Those are bell peppers, the inside a room from inside the Manil, and the grocery cart seat where the red flaps are. And the tree comes from in front of the Manil. I just combined all of those together real quickly. And it's on foam board. It was kind of difficult to paint on foam board. Everything dries fast and sometimes it peels up, so I kind of repainted it to make it stick a little more. And the wood floors are just, I just drew in the wood panels instead of drawing it, painting it brown. I painted the color of the cards that the bell peppers are sitting in. For this one, I used the Michael Heiser sculpture again, but another section of it, and I replaced the grass with candy-coated almonds from Fiesta. I was basically showing the contrast between the mottledness of the candy-coated almonds with the flatness of the steel from the Michael Heiser sculpture. This one, I used one of the masks from inside the Manil, painted it in the colors of the candy-coated almonds, and then placed them all on the shelf from Fiesta with the tags, and then have one of these little wood mannequins that we sometimes draw in art class, that they have one inside the Manil, and place them in there as if he's looking around. And then I use some of the eyes are from one of the little ancient figurines, and one of the eyes are from the logo of Fiesta. So, you know, look real closely at that. And that's on the cover of a drawing pad, the paper. Because I like the texture that was on it, so I used that instead of a regular canvas. The last one is foam board. It's cut in the shape of the action sign from the Fiesta cell paper. And inside that, I have the Fiesta's logo, the parrot, painted on that. And on top of the parrot, I painted a Rothko on top as some color grounds, and then on top of that I painted lines to follow the shape of the action sign as if Frank Stella did with his shape supports. And then on top of that I painted the installation of Dan Flavin, And on top of that, I painted some lines that are inspired by the wood panels of the outside walls, of the Manila.